unfortunately, in 2010, after an invasive procedure, after lung biopsy, it was discovered that I had a constrictive bronchiolitis with fibrosis.
We have a burn pit down here.
It was the noxious fumes from burn pits that were used on U.S. military bases in Iraq and Afghanistan to dispose of everything from plastic water bottles and batteries to tires, electronic equipment, and paint cans.
I am here at BioXcellerator in Medellin, Colombia, to receive treatment for my toxic brain injury and to my lung injury that I received after being exposed to burn pit exposure while I was deployed to Balad, Iraq. My career, sir, being dual role citizen soldier, serving in the reserves, being a company commander, being a state patrolman. I could juggle both careers with no problem. And now to sit down and actually put some thoughts together, even words together at times, has been a challenge.
Didn't have any doctors to go visit. You know, he was top-notch, top health. Pre-deployment exam was flying colors. After war, right, my husband didn't come home, you know. Man, we went crashing down at 100 miles per hour after, like, the minute that he touched foot on U.S. soil. Financial hardship, loss of both our jobs, our kids having to just see the ugly side of war.
To war, I had 30 days to prepare, and within 30 days, I was in Iraq. But here, 13 years later, I'm trying to receive specialized health care. You know, it's nonsense.
I know who I married, and I know who stepped foot on that plane, but I also know who came back, and I feel like he's been gone for such a long time. I really have a lot of hope that he's coming back slowly, right? And he'll be here fully eventually as the year goes by and the treatment begins to take its course.
Challenge after challenge, it has been very draining, not only physically, emotionally, but also financially. I had the IV infusion. I had a series of two infusions through IV of stem cell, plus the intrathecal procedure where they injected my back with actual stem cell for the toxic brain injury. So it was a total of three procedures.
I put out here, battling the war that followed us home, hashtag burn pits, hashtag toxic exposure. This has been an issue that not only myself have been battling for the last 13 years, but that there's an estimated 3.5 million veterans that have been affected, and that this here is our way of saying to these toxic exposure issues that we battled, that now this is a way to us is going to help us overcome this war that we have been, that followed us. This war, that a piece of war came back with us, and we're gonna today, I believe that we're gonna face this issue, this beast today.
I believe that stem cells can actually open doors for a breakthrough in the invisible wounds that not only myself battle, but that there's thousands and possibly millions. You know, it's estimated that 3.5 million veterans have been affected from toxic exposure over this two-decade length of war, of wars. I believe this is going to be a breakthrough in the care for veterans, because time is of essence, because other veterans don't have the time that I do. Some are already under deathbeds. They're terminal. They're dealing with terminal condition. And I believe that this is going to be a breakthrough with BioXcellerator in the treatment that I received, and that I'll be able to go home, and that in due time I'll be able to function much better than what I have in the last 13 years.